So now we know some ways to make comparisons. We want to use them to make decisions, to make our code do something different depending on the result of a comparison. The way to do that is to use an if statement. The structure of an if statement is we have the keyword if, followed by a comparison. We'll call that the test expression, followed by a colon. And then inside the if, we have the block. And the block is the code that will run when the test expression is true. If the test expression doesn't evaluate to true, then the block doesn't execute. And as with the procedure definitions, we know the end of the if because of indentation. All the statements inside the block are executed only when the test expression is true. The next statement that's not indented is going to be executed whether or not the test expression is true. So here's an example of a procedure that uses if. We can define a procedure absolute. It takes one input, which is a number. Inside the body of absolute, we're going to use an if statement. We'll use an if test where we're testing if the value of x is less than 0. So that's the test expression. We have the if followed by the test expression, x is less than 0. In the block, we're going to have one statement which changes the value of x to be negative x. The next statement, which will happen after the if, whether the test was true or false, will return x. So what this does is gives us the absolute value of the number that's passed in. If the number that's passed in is negative, we take its opposite, we use its negation, and then we return. If the number is positive, this test will be false, so we don't execute the block that changes the value of x to its negation. We'll go right to the statement that returns x. So now it's time for a quiz to see if you understand how to use if and can use it to define a procedure. Your goal for this quiz is to define a procedure called bigger that takes in two numbers as its inputs and it outputs the greater of the two inputs. So here are a few examples. If the inputs are 2 and 7, the greater input is 7 and the output should be 7. If the inputs are 3 and 2, the greater input is 3 and so the output should be 3. If the two inputs are the same, say 3 and 3, the output should be 3.